Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. According to the World Health Organization, there are around 268,000 new cases of breast cancer every year. Mm-hmm. And annually, there are about 62,000 deaths from the disease. Unfortunately, the lack of awareness makes early diagnosis an uphill task. Fortunately for us, Dr. April Spencer is here to keep us on top of breast cancer awareness and help us know the risks and how to deal with it. Mm-hmm. Please welcome Dr. April Spencer.
Yay. Looking gorgeous.
Yes, honey, you are slaying the people in your lab jacket, girl.
Appreciate that.
She looks great.
Before we jump into the risks, let's talk about the symptoms and what we should look for. We all know we should check for masses and we should check for lumps, but what are the other symptoms we should look for?
Trina, great question. The thing about breast cancer is that a lot of times people focus on lumps in the breast. And to your point, oftentimes there can be other signs and symptoms like nipple discharge, changes in the skin, redness, thickening of the breast. That can be risk factors. And this is even important for men, because as you know, of that number, 1% are diagnosed in men, and Matthew Knowles was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. And so a lot of my male patients aren't aware that they too can get breast cancer. And so it's very important that we mentioned that there are many things that can be risk factors in our anatomy.
What does thickness of the breast mean? What does that mean?
It just means that there's one area that may be more prominent than the other, and so you just have to know your breasts. And the thing is, if you see something, say something.
Okay.
And oftentimes when we think of a monthly breast exam, we think of feeling for
a lump.
Right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of times what's happening is women will ignore all the other signs. They'll say, okay, it's not a lump, so it must be okay
that I'm having
a nipple discharge.
How do you know that you're just not ashy?
Well,
that's a good question.
Absolutely. That's when it persists, meaning it doesn't go away. Mm-hmm. So if you're seeing your dermatologist, you're seeing your doctor, and you've done the lotions, the creams, and it persists, that needs to be biopsied.
Wow.
And so don't just assume that it's, you know, you're dry or it's a flare up of your eczema,
and
that sort of thing.
I want to ask too, in the crease up underneath the breast, sometimes there's chafing from anything, sweating. Could that be a symptom? Or is the redness on top or around?
So usually the redness is on top. Okay. That's called the inflammatory fold, like right underneath the bottom, but that's a diagnosis of inflammatory breast cancer where there's no lump, the breast is just red, hot, and inflamed. Mm. And a lot of times women, and you know, may think, hey, I just had a bug bite or I have a rash. Mm-hmm. So you have something that persists, meaning it doesn't go away with just your traditional treatment, you must go see your healthcare provider.
Before I ask the question that we're prepared for, I have cystic breasts, so I'm lumpy anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For people like me, what do I need to do and be more vigilant of when I'm doing my breast exams?
Yeah. And that the bottom line is you just have to know your breasts, like know your normal, and don't just focus on what your breasts feel like, but if you see something different, say something. It's not always about feeling for a lump or a cystic. It's just, maybe it's just that cyst again. Mm-hmm. And so I always share with women, even if you've had cysts in the past, this could be something a little different. So still make sure you share that with your healthcare provider.
Right, absolutely.
And be your own advocate. Because a lot of times people will brush us off as women and say, oh, it's just a cyst, or, you know, we biopsied that last year. Make sure you still follow up.
Stay on it.
What about if you get a clean, you know, a clean mammogram, but you do have these symptoms? Would a mammogram be able to detect that if you had the other symptoms and not the lump?
Go ahead, Lena.
Exactly, not always. So that's why it's really important to get your screening mammogram. Oof. Sometimes those mammograms can be normal, but you gotta be your own advocate. So if you still feel that there's something not right with your breast, make sure you let someone know.
Is breast cancer genetic?
You know, that's a misconception. There is a genetic component, but it's a minority of it. It's only 5 to 10%.
Okay.
So most of us are still at risk.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, got it.
Mm.
Wow.
Okay, so speaking of risk, what are some of the risk factors of breast cancer?
Some of the risk factors of breast cancer include anything from having a family history, having a genetic component, obesity is a risk factor, hormonal factors like having a late period, having your period start early or menopause late. And one thing that we don't really talk a lot about is infertility can be a risk factor. We call it nulliparity, meaning you haven't had children or a live birth before, or delayed childbirth. That's a risk factor. Now, I'm not suggesting we all go out
and
conceive because of that, but we see this in a lot of African-American women because, you know, African-American women, we have the most educated demographic in the United States. And with that comes a lot of stress, a lot of what I call ambition addiction. Mm-hmm. Wow. We delay childbirth. We delay fertility. Absolutely. Cool. And so those things can put us at a slightly increased risk. So,
So let's talk a little bit about age. Does the risk factor go up with age?
Yes. So your risk for getting breast cancer does increase in age. But what I'm seeing and what we're seeing nationally is that we see a spike in young women or women under 40 in new cases or incidents of breast cancer. Wow. And so it's really important to talk to our girlfriends, to our colleagues, that that's something that's...
You have given us so much information that we want to make sure we keep you for the next segment.
Yes.
Next segment. So
yes.
We'll be back
more
with Dr.
questions.
April Spencer when we return.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. And getting back, segueing back to breast cancer and diagnosis, when you get the call, how do you deal with getting breast cancer diagnosed?
Yes. So when you get that call, the first thing that usually happens is there is something abnormal on your mammogram. If you get a call back, go back, because it's not always breast cancer. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of times our treatment is not completely realized because we allow the fear to stop us from getting further treatment. So the main thing is make sure you get a good care team that you're aligned with, even if that means getting a first or a second or even a third opinion, because the journey is too important to not be wrong in the same direction. The other thing is make sure you have a good support system. We shouldn't suffer in silence. So if there's something going on, make sure you have a trusted relative or a friend, and just do it on your own timeline. That's super important. And then lastly, just make sure that you are getting yourself back in the driver's seat of like your mental, emotional, and spiritual health. It's the best opportunity to start putting yourself first again.
Awesome. Tell us about this big event you're having this upcoming June.
June 2020. So it's a women's wellness retreat from your breast health to your best health. So it's geared towards breast cancer survivors, thrivers, and women that just want to reduce cancers in their life. So that can be relationships, jobs, men.
Cancers in your life.
Absolutely.
Right.
So it's June 11th through the 14th. So it's June 2020 in Costa Rica.
That's fantastic.
You can learn more about this conference at DrAprilSpencer.com.
All right.
Is that where
Dr.
I can follow
April
you?
Spencer.
Yes, Dr.
That's
April.
Right.